Next question. How many siblings do you have? I have 8 siblings. 8 plus me, making it 9. So plus my parents are making it a one great soccer team. Next. What college did you go to? In Nigeria, my first college is called University of Calabar. University of Calabar. That was the first college I went to. In Europe, I attended in Holland University, or you can call it Holland International Business School. In the United States, I attended UCLA, University of California, Los Angeles. There is another college that I attended today, though that didn't last long, but I'm just telling you the ones that I had certification from. Okay, next question is, when did you work with computers and for how long? If you're talking about Maryland, if you're specifying in Maryland, it's from 2011 to 2015 and partly 2016. It was 5 years in Maryland. Before that time, in Nigeria, it was longer. And even before the Maryland own, I was a consultant on my own. So I didn't work for anybody, but people were, you know, consulting me. And I was giving them the services they need, and then they were paying me. That one I did in California. So next is, if you could do anything besides teaching right now, what would it be? This is kind of funny. Well, I have not really dropped my IT consulting. So I will just switch back to that one immediately. I have not really dropped it completely. And that's why I don't participate in many other after school activities, so that I can do those things. All right. So I got into teaching for a specific reason, for a particular reason. You really don't want to know that. Maybe I can tell you if you ask, but I don't have to teach to survive. That's the point. I do not have to teach to survive. I can do many, many other things. So the advantage of teaching, if I can tell you, let me actually tell you now so that you don't think that I'm hiding anything. I'm not hiding anything. The advantage of teaching is, and this is major for me, is out of 365 days in a year, I can just work for 180 days. And I get money that is equivalent to 365 days. In other words, I have 3 months that I don't have to deal with anything teaching, but I still get money from teaching. I don't know if that's making sense. All right? So that's huge for me. That's huge. For example, during the long vacation, you know, you spend two months relaxing at home or going to somewhere. I know how I spend my own 2 months. Now, all these other holidays that are in between, like the Easter holiday, Thanksgiving holiday, Christmas holiday, and all these periods, if you add them up, it's another 1 month right there. If you join another job full time, you can hardly get 2 weeks of vacation time. You can hardly get it. All right? I don't know if that answers that question. So that's huge. Another big reason is, there are some benefits in the employment benefits that are not available in many other professions. There is also a third reason is there's also a strong union. You know what is union? Union tend to protect their members, which is the workers. So sometimes students think that they have rights. Yes, they do. But the rights of the students are small, very little compared to the rights of the teachers. I don't know if you know that. Okay. If the student right and responsibility is like this, this thing, like this, that of the teacher is like this, huge, it's big. I'm just letting you know. So next question, can you please say something in Igbo? Yes, I can, that's what I speak. So it depends on what you want me to say. I can greet in it, that's what I speak every day. So I can say hello, I can say, just say ndewonu. Good morning, Una Bolachi, and I can say anything you want. So next question is, do you think that Duval has gotten better school-wise? The answer is yes. However, Duval hasn't really been a bad school. It hasn't really been. What did I say? Duval has not really been a bad school. Now, what you get out of Duval is what you deserve. If you come to Duval to learn, absolutely you are going to learn. Are there resources at Duval? Absolutely, 100%. There are more resources at Duval than many other schools, or at least they are not lagging. That's the point I want to make. Are there fantastic teachers at Duval? 100% yes. Fantastic, great teachers with high qualification and high experience. So don't have the impression that Duval is a bad school. No, it is not. If you come to Duval to learn, you are absolutely going to learn. Many Duval scholars, many Duval students are in Ivy League colleges. At least two of my students. One is in Princeton. Princeton is Ivy League. Another one is in Columbia University. That's Ivy League. I mean, the ones I know I taught. And there are more who could have gotten there if they actually pushed for it. So Duval is a good school. Now, has it gotten better? I would say yes. Here's why I would say yes. When I got to Duval, the principal we had that time, one principal left. So they did not really get another principal, but they got an assistant principal who was acting for the principal. But unfortunately, the acting principal, he was sick. He was sick, unfortunately. He was really sick. So he wasn't really coming. You know, he wasn't really coming the way he ought to be. And then Miss Smith, fantastic principal, good, great principal. She comes all the time. She does what she needs to do and things are working. Okay? So Duval is a great school, believe me. And more importantly, let me tell you this. This is what you guys are not understanding. The state government, Maryland and PGCPS, they specially picked Duval to get funding for so many programs. For example, the aerospace program. How many other schools around that are doing aerospace programs? How many other schools around that are doing all these Project Lead the Way and all those stuff that are being offered at Duval? And they are still investing in Duval. Okay.